Hey, Cancer, it's me. Let's talk relationships. Let's talk relationships. Let's take a look at the relationships in your life. Welcome back to the Cancerian channel if you're new here. Hey, I haven't met you before. What's up? Hit the subscribe button. We can hang out more often. Let's take a look at what's going on with your relationship. What do you need to know? Let's just talk. We're just hanging out. There's always a message for life in every one of my videos. And we just hang out together. And we don't take it too seriously. That's how we do things over here. Okay? So, life, friendships, your gardener, your boyfriend, your F buddy. Let's just see what wants to come out around Cancer right now. Oh! All right, dropping the load, peace of mind. Okay, so there's a relationship in your life that, oh child, it is burdensome. My oh my, it's like it's a headache, and I think you're tired of thinking about it. And you, let me see. Yeah, exactly. It's a headache. The Five of Swords is my headache card as well. It's just a headache. And I'm not surprised that even in this picture, girlfriend here is like holding her head. She needs a hot compress. Like, this is a situation. It's just like, I can't believe I said what I said. I can't believe that person did that thing. There's a bit of a disappointment here within your relationships. Whatever the relationship is, it could just be with family, just... You may be a little bit disappointed by the way a family member is handling something. I'm hearing like handling the care of somebody. That's a specific message for someone. But overall, I'm getting a sense generally right now, you are like, look, I can't take it on. I'm feeling a lot of feelings right now and you don't understand how I feel. So I'm just going to leave you alone and find my peace of mind. Like, I kind of see Cancer being like that. Okay, so... What is this headache, though? I'm curious. What is this headache or this emotional upset, this grief here? Okay, you walked away, or somebody walked away from you, or somebody... This is like, it's kind of like you're not emotionally content. And I have a feeling that you've been wanting this person or this situation to fulfill you in a way that it isn't. And I think maybe you even came to them with this and they did not respond or react in a way that was helpful to you at all. So you're moving on. It just feels like an energy of moving on here. Somebody's turning their back on something. You or this person, yeah, you're headed towards, you want to like receive more from your relationships. This could even be a friendship. It's like, it's just every time you talk to Trish, it's just, oh my god, the headache of it all, and you're just over it, and you want relationships that look a little bit more like this, a little bit more fun. You want to help. You want others to help you the way you help them. Like, you want it to be balanced and you feel like you're always the one that's giving 90%. When am I gonna get some? That's kind of what I'm getting here. So I have a feeling, Cancer, that it's you that's turning your back on this. So what's going on around you? Okay, you get the Empress. Look, I see here, it's almost like your angels and guides are supporting you in this decision that you're making to put yourself first. And if that's not the decision you're making, then that's your guidance. You need to put yourself first. You can't control anything other than you and your state of mind. And I feel like you have a lot of amazing things to look forward to. It's like you're starting your own family. You're wanting to start your own family. And you just don't have time for people that drain your energy. Look at these beautiful cards. Ooh, child. You have a lot to look forward to when it comes to your relationships. Let's just see. What does Cancer have to look forward to here? Tell me a little bit more about this Empress, Ten of Pentacles. You guys are starting a family. You met somebody. that you're going to have a really long-term situation with. Ooh, yeah, you're probably getting an offer from a Virgo. Okay, so what you have to look forward to, Cancer, it's almost like you've been in hermit mode, doing your own thing, working on your laptop, being the adorable Queen of Cups here, right? And somebody sees your worth and they want the same thing you do. Your ground is very fertile. Some of you, it's like your eggs are very fertile. Your sperm is very fertile, kind of thing. So, you know, be careful about that if that's not what you want. But I see someone making you a solid offer here and they want long-term, you know, and it's going to take you going in a new direction to activate this new energy. If you stay with the headache situation, you will be here in bed, bitching and moaning, needing a hot compress. Okay, so let's see what else is going on within your relationship. Anything else I'm missing here? A lot of you are really, it's like you have a grandmother or something that's living with you, or a mother that's living with you. That's maybe the headache here. But I feel like if you have a family member coming to live with you, I actually think it's going to be a good thing. I do. Or you're moving closer to the family. There's an essence here of being around others and helping others and receiving help from somebody else or receiving something from somebody else. Let's see. Yeah, there's been some kind of change that's why it's like maybe there was a death in the family that's requiring you guys to move together. Or you're going through something. Somebody's going through something and you're requiring support. So this change, I feel like, is you ending all of the BS, the relationship ending, the friendship ending. You're just transforming in a way that requires you to make different choices and have different actions when it comes to you, your family, what you want in the future, your friendships, your relationships. Yeah. Something you had that was long-term ended for some of you. I see you here, bottom of the deck, really getting your balance. Stella getting her groove back, working on herself, practicing self-love and boundaries and not trying to be everything to everyone. What else is coming through? Yeah, you're working, like I said, on your little laptop. Is that a laptop? And a painting, etch-a-sketch? What is this? This is cute. You're busy. Yeah, you're busy, boo. Look at this, all this pentacle energy. So a lot of you are really focused on your money. That's why you're in this kind of hermit mode. Some of you, you're starting a spiritual business and you really were trying to make more money. Yeah. What else? Damn, you are all about the cash. Virgo season. Okay, look, I'm about it. It makes sense. I said this in your September reading. Like, it's not like, okay. So basically, here's what's going on with your relationships. There's been an ending. There's change being initiated, but it's absolutely positive. It's like forcing you to put yourself first. You're doing away with all the BS, all of the friendships, the relationships that haven't anchored in a way that feels good to you. You're disconnecting. This is like energy of you're blocking, you're moving, you're literally relocating. Some of you have family members coming to stay with you. You are going to get an offer from somebody. Be mindful that if you want connection, accept this offer, because I feel like you might be really head buried in the books or in whatever you're doing that you don't even see this person trying to help you. This could be an offer of like support, a really good friendship. Look out for a water sign coming into your life, trying to talk to you, trying to help you, trying to connect with you. It seems like that's something good for you, okay? Be mindful of impatience and lack mentality when it comes to your relationships. Okay, being impatient, waiting for somebody to do something. We don't have time to wait. You booked and busy. We don't have time. You on this train or you not on this train? Do you know what I'm saying? It's like you coming on board or you're not, because I have things to do. And some of you, I think the impatience you're feeling is the answer. It's the answer. You need to shift your energy, fall back, go back, way back, more back, do your own thing, be the boss of your own life. Damn, you got Emperor energy here, Cancer. Wow. Bossing up, being the boss of your own life, and that is leading to this new offer, this new relationship, and your chariot seat is upright. You're headed in a new direction. You're confident and you're ready, and you're the boss right now. In September, I mean, I told you, I'm glad it's coming out here in your relationship reading. Some of you are connecting with the Cancer, a Sagittarius, or an Aries that's going to be entering your life, and you're taking it slow. You're not prioritizing them at all. You're like, look, I'll try to fit you into the schedule, but all right, Venus is in Cancer. That's what this is. Look at this. That's what this is. Look, I'm shining, booked and busy, glowing, flowing, grounded, abundant. You are. You are. So people can smell it on you. Just don't settle and don't deal with the headaches if you don't have to. You have the power to do this. Turn around. Turn your back. Keep walking. Head in the direction of balance, reciprocity, equal give and take. Yes, you can help people. Do so with love and without expectation and keep it pushing. Okay? Nice. Let's get some out of here. What's going on for Cancer in their relationships? I'm thirsty. Okay. What's going on for Cancer in their relationship? Attached. Yeah. I don't see you being attached anymore. You're literally dropping all that crap you were carrying, so that's good. Somebody else may be attached here. Okay, let's see. Feeling alone. Not for long. You have confusion. Focused on you. Somebody is focused on you. This person that's coming in your direction. You may have been feeling alone. And you have this person focused on you. Yeah, surprise coming your way. Do not be afraid of this. There's fear here. And you see positive outcome and past relationship coming out. Interesting. I feel like you were once attached to this past relationship. You were confused, right? And now I do see here that you maybe even have a new person. The universe is gonna surprise you here. You got gaslighting coming out. Maybe this other person, somebody was gaslighting you, this family member, this friend, whatever it is. Okay, so remember I said long term, you have a positive outcome, a long-term situation anchoring in your life. Okay, you're focused on the future, you're focused on abundance, on building. I love it. Let's get one last one. Anything else? Happy. Perfect card to end on. Ooh, and commitment at the bottom of the deck. Yeah, I love it. I love it, Cancer. I hope that this has been helpful to you. Everything you need to know is in the description box below. Follow me on my other channel. I'll link it here. I love you, babe. I'll see you later.